whether in the dormant seed or in the towering tree. We see equally striking changes of state in the animal kingdom. So, for example, picture the metamorphosis of a caterpillar becoming a butterfly. This change of state is not merely growth and maturation, it's a complete transformation into something that would appear to be a completely different organism. Again, same DNA, whether it's crawling as a caterpillar or fluttering as a butterfly. And today, you undergo a sea change. The metamorphosis from student to a clinician en route to becoming a physician. You unlock that potential degree by degree through study, classes, labs. The responsibility to help care for patients, heal the sick, is, however, profoundly different than studying in class. It builds on your acquired knowledge and skills, yet it also requires you to think, to act, and I would say to comport yourselves in a completely different manner. Correspondingly, the rewards, intellectually, emotionally, and even spiritually, increase exponentially. As you walk across the stage, you cross a threshold from which there is no turning back. The steps you take today are not incremental, they're transformational. This white coat ceremony celebrates this metamorphosis. You've already experienced rites of passage that commemorate important moments of life, your births, transition to adulthood, perhaps marriage. At Sonoran University, the stethoscope ceremony heralded your entry to medical school, and in less than 2 years, commencement will mark the next phase in your journey. Your white coat also conveys another deeper message or feeling. Bless you. It helps you separate your sacred activities from the ordinary. And I'm talking about sacred in a very broad sense. When you change into your white coat prior to seeing a patient, you step out of your ordinary lives. You know, you're committing that experience to the health and well-being of another human being. And so the drive to the medical center or your clinic or wherever it is that you're going, mundane conversations, et cetera, are things that we carry with us. I have a friend who is a Buddhist monk who said that 80% of our lived experience happens in our head, only 20% is what we actually do. And so all of these things we carry around with us as we go throughout our days. And so I ask you to think about when you put on your white coat, to use the act of donning your white coat to pause, take a breath, and reflect on the sanctity of the moment, your calling to help heal the sick. Whatever meaning you impart, I urge you to make the most of these next 2 years. Your intention, preparation, and follow-up will help shape your patient encounters and the depth of your learning and understanding that you gain. And so approach this work with reverence. Congratulations to each of you for the hard work, the dedication, and perseverance that help you reach this milestone on your journey to becoming naturopathic physicians. On behalf of your teachers, attending physicians, and all of us who work at Sonoran, we wish you success and learning over the next 2 years. Best wishes. God bless.
Thank you, Dr. Mittman, for your insights. At this time, we'd like to take a moment to recognize the student leaders who have helped steer their class to this point in their journey and who have made this celebration possible today. Their hard work and altruistic drive provide a source of cohesion and camaraderie for their class. Please stand to be recognized as I call your name. Class President Juliana Maza. Vice President Alyssa Gilchrist. Treasurer Shad Abdullah. And Secretary Adriana Watson. Thank you for all your hard work. It is a tradition of the White Coat Ceremony to gain insight into the experiences that have brought the class of fall 2025 to this point in their journey. Today's class speaker is Juliana Maza. While there are many students who could speak on behalf of this cohort, they thought that out of all the qualified candidates, Juliana could best represent their many characteristics of her cohort. Dedication, camaraderie, perseverance, empathy, and academic curiosity. Here to share the class of fall 2025's journey thus far, Miss Juliana Maza.
Okay, good morning, everyone, and welcome again to this very momentous occasion. I would also like to start by addressing all the friends, family, and loved ones who are here in person, those joining us online, and those unable to attend. On behalf of our entire cohort, thank you. Although we often rely on our classmates, esteemed faculty, and the Sonoran community, we would not be here today without all of your unwavering support. You've all played a critical role in our ability to be here today, so truly, thank you. As I sat down to reflect on how to encapsulate our experiences during the first half of our studies and describe our academic journey thus far in just a few minutes, it was a seemingly daunting task. I initially thought, how will I follow up the amazing speeches before me, and how do I live up to my classmates' expectations? But quickly, I realized that I should take the same approach that a naturopathic doctor does with their patients, completely individualized and bespoke. That had me further reflecting on our first 2 years here at Sonoran University. I can recall the very first day of orientation where we all introduced ourselves and the story behind what led us to naturopathic medicine. It was that very day that I grew such an appreciation for the community at our school. This is because we all have vastly different backgrounds, experiences, interests, and journeys that brought us here together. However, we all share a profound passion for addressing the whole person, whole health, and the root cause of disease. It has been said that health is not simply the absence of sickness, and I can wholeheartedly say that although as a cohort we all have different interests, we are bound by the deep passion that is whole person health. As a cohort, we have undergone a transformational journey of bonding, growth, and learning. From being the first cohort back to in-person cadaver exams, adapting to the shifts of post-pandemic learning, and delving into the principles of naturopathic medicine, our minds have been stretched, our perspectives broadened, and our passion for healing ignited. The road to get here has been challenging yet rewarding. And although we will continue to face challenges and push ourselves to new limits, let us not forget how far we have come individually, but more importantly, together. There have been many times throughout these first 2 years of learning the pieces to the puzzle that have felt overbearing and too much to overcome. But classmates, if you look around at each other, please share a smile, because together we have made it through these challenges, which is a testament to how capable we are and the dedication to our future patients. As we embark on this next phase of our journey, we will begin to put these puzzle pieces together. Let us draw upon the knowledge, skills, cultivated resilience, and curiosity that we have developed over these last few years as we step into our role as healers. The significance of the white coats that we receive today extend far beyond their plain white fabric. They signify the next phase in our journey towards becoming naturopathic doctors. White coats have been a long-standing symbolism for physicians dating back to the 1800s. Although they were a representation of cleanliness and professionalism, our white coats represent far more than that today. They embody the trust bestowed in us by our future patients, the responsibility of having the health of others in our hands, and the privilege of healing that we are donned with as future physicians. As we accept these white coats today, we are reaffirming our commitment to serve, to heal, and to uphold the highest standards of care and approach our patients with empathy, dedication, respect, and support. We shall never cease our curiosity of learning and continue to strive for excellence. With that, I would like to ask all of you to continue challenging yourself while engaging your hearts. Let us embrace this transition from classroom to clinic while upholding the Sonoran University core values. We will shape the future by advocating for our medicine, collaborating with others, and pursuing our degree with purpose. We will achieve excellence by surpassing the bar that we have set for ourselves and continuing to improve each day. We love by embracing diversity, empowering inclusivity, and living by positivity. We will do the right thing by embracing the principles of naturopathic medicine, holding ourselves accountable, and living with integrity. Lastly, we are resilient as we work with others, accept challenges, and appreciate inquiry. Let us remember to always encapsulate the essence of naturopathic medicine, emphasizing its focus on prevention and the healing power of nature. So to my fellow classmates, I want to extend my deepest appreciation for the opportunity to speak on behalf of our cohort, for the challenges, support, and shared experiences that have defined our journey thus far. Throughout these past 2 years, we have forged bonds that will endure a lifetime, united by our passion for holistic care and our shared commitment to making a meaningful difference in the lives of others. I want to personally congratulate each and every one of you and reiterate that I am truly grateful for each individual that comprises our cohort. I could not be more excited to continue growing together as we embrace this next exciting stage of our journeys to becoming NDs. I would like to end with a quote that I have always loved, but I've found even more valuable in this medical school journey. You are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you, Juliana. The medical school journey is not an easy one. The path to becoming a doctor is vigorous and tiring. However, with them on this journey have been their faculty. These dedicated teachers have motivated, urged, challenged, and sometimes hauled these students through copious amounts of medical information and practices. However, without these committed educators, this class would not be here today. In particular, the class would like to recognize one teacher who they feel summed up their basic medical sciences experience to date and represents an outstanding commitment to the students by awarding them the Foundational Sciences Award. Today's recipient is an alumni of Sonoran University, class of 2018. He is also the owner of Wild Horse Health, a clinic focusing on traumatic injury recovery and conservative pain management. When not managing his clinic, this faculty member can be found using his many dedicated years of dissection experience, helping students in the anatomy lab. Receiving the International Faculty of the Year Award from the Naturopathic Medical Student Association, as well as past Sonoran Foundational Sciences Awards and Faculty Honors Awards. Additionally, his research has been published in the Phytotherapy Research Journal, and he is currently working on protocols for managing whiplash and whiplash-related disorders. The class felt that this faculty member deserves the Foundational Sciences Award because he has a true passion for teaching. He is exceedingly patient with the students and always goes the extra mile to make sure they truly understand the materials and become proficient and its applications, empowering them as future doctors. He cares about his students and his thoughtful approach to teaching and steadfast professionalism, making him an incredible professor worthy of this award. This year's Foundational Sciences Award winner and today's faculty speaker is Dr. Anthony Panazza.
Thank you very much for this. This is awesome. All right. Well, thank you so much for that. I don't have much to say, so I'll go very quickly so we can get to the main event. But First of all, I would like to thank all of you. I'm honored that you chose me to be your faculty speaker. So very, very excited to be here today. And then now I would like to interact and talk specifically to the family and friends in the room. So you guys have supported these students, and this is a huge, huge landmark moment. They have completed 2 years of mass quantities of information, some of it extremely nerdy, some of it extremely intricate. I would like to first say thank you, because you have endured the stress, the tears, the inevitable, hey, let me practice this exam on you. And then as they got further, it kind of sounds like you might have that condition. They would not have gotten this far without you guys supporting them. So thank you. Now to the class. I first met you guys in anatomy dissection lab 2 years ago with all of our favorites, Dr. Munt. Woo! Based on everyone's faces in the wet lab, I know this probably was not the most ideal place to meet your instructors for the first time. So shortly after the adjustment period, which ranges anywhere from 2 hours to we're still adjusting, and mild therapy during class period, we got to see everybody's personalities actually come out. And that is my personal favorite. So this is where we get to find out why you came here. What is the whole point of the reason coming to Sonoran? Why you wanted to go into medicine? That's some of my favorite stuff to hear. So as we were going through anatomy, there were some tears, mostly because of the smelly bodies. But after that, we definitely got to see you guys become you, and it was a lot of fun. Now, there were several stories that came out. The common thread that tied all of them together was you want to make a solid difference in naturopathic medicine and in patient care. Now, sadly, after 9 long, smelly, sometimes excruciating months of education, Dr. Munt and I had to say bye to you because you're ready to move on to the next stage. That next stage was gen med. Now, detouring just for a second for everybody else, gen med is that class. You have heard about gen med. It is the class that they talk about. Everybody has definitely talked about this one. It's general medicine. It's where they learn everything. So now you know the reference point. So we enter gen med, and I know you guys did amazing because you're sitting here today. And you learned everything about so many conditions. I once asked Dr. Howell how many conditions, and we were above 100. That's just all you need to know, above 100. Now, when you left that class, you knew a lot of information, and you also probably had at least 10 self-diagnoses. It's a normal thing, it's fine. Now, here's the part that I think is the most exciting. So 12 weeks ago, you guys got to meet up with us for a review for boards. This is where Dr. Munt and I were very privileged to see how much you guys have learned. So in 12 hours, we reviewed what took you 9 months to learn. So we did that in 12 hours, but it didn't stop there. You started rattling off conditions, microbiology, immunology, pathophysiology, all of the ologies that you've learned so far. Now, excuse me. I hope you all noticed the same thing that we did. I don't know if you did. So in that case, I'm going to tell you. You guys are very smart. You have learned a lot. And you know what you're talking about. And all the hard work that you've done to get to this point, it shows. So as Dr. Mittman and Juliana said, this ceremony indicates a transition from learning to learning while doing. 2 years is quite a long time, and you've used a lot of brain cells. You're about to use a whole lot more. And it's very exciting because you're going to start interacting with patients so you can see the changes that you've been studying so, so hard for. Now, as you move into the white coat today, I would take a moment and try to remember back what you told me and Dr. Munt that you, why you got into this. It's a very good moment to do that. Put on the white coat and remember that reason. Now, all of you know that I am a little bit of a nerd, and I tend to do deep dives. I want to leave you with a little nugget of wisdom from a very skittish wizard from one of the novels that I read. It is vital to remember who you are. It's very, very important. It isn't a good idea to rely on people or other things to do that for you, because they'll always get it wrong. So you have to know who you are. Thank you all very much. I'm very honored to be up here today. And one more thing, as you go into clinical medicine, you must remember this. What are the borders of the pterygomaxillary fissure? See you guys.
Congratulations, Dr. Panazza, on your Foundational Sciences Award and your words of wisdom. Now it is time to celebrate the primary reason for our ceremony today, the transition from didactic student focused on lectures, labs, and demonstrations to student clinician utilizing their medical knowledge to assist real patients as they progress towards their ultimate goal of healing professionals. The white coat that the students receive this afternoon is an outward symbol of that transition. So at this time, I ask the class and any honored guests to please stand and follow the ushers backstage to prepare for the presentation of the students. While the students prepare, I would like to introduce the individuals who will be participating in the remainder of the ceremony. Cloaking the students in their white coats is Dr. Joseph Vasquez. Dr. Vasquez is the Associate Dean of Clinical Education and is representing the transition of these students from their didactic studies to the practice of medicine. Dr. Vasquez has been practicing medicine since 2013, with a focus in general medicine, physical medicine, and cardiology. Excuse me. After graduation from the National University of Health Sciences with a doctorate of naturopathic medicine, Dr. Vasquez created the first clinical summative assessment to target students' learning outcomes and programmatic competencies. Dr. Vasquez has been active in several medical organizations and councils, and has been an editor for the Gale Encyclopedia of Alternate Medicine, 6th edition, and is a member of the New England Journal of Medicine Insights Council. Reading the names of today's white coat recipients will be the Chief Medical Officer of Sonoran University, Dr. Kimberly Blyden-Taylor. Dr. Blyden-Taylor has combined clinical practice, service, teaching, and academia for most of her career. She taught at the Canadian College of Naturopathic Medicine, founded the Red Hawk Healing Arts Health Clinic, served as Associate Dean of Clinical Education, and Chair of the Homeopathy Department at the Canadian College of Naturopathic Medicine. Dr. Blyden-Taylor is a well-known speaker and lecturer, and has been a regular guest lecturer at numerous colleges and universities. Along with Dr. Vasquez and Dr. Blyden-Taylor, our president, Dr. Paul Mittman, will once again be joining them on stage to welcome the students to clinical training. So without any further delay, today's white coat recipients.
Shad Abdullah. Austin Akers. Ashley Amiri. Malena Kennedy. Catherine Andrew. Kim Kamek. Bethany Costa. Alexandria Deeker. Catherine Fisher. Joseph Funches. Alyssa Gilchrist, Float by Dr. Ann Shaw. Kristen Griggs. Mariah Hawkins. Hannah Howells. Aaron Kelsa. Arishna Marshall. Mayild Martinez. Juliana Maza. Natasha McKenzie, cloaked by Dr. Alexis McKenzie. Candace Meekum. Tola Oinuga. Priya Patel, cloaked by Dr. Satish Kumar Patel. Janessa Reyes Colocado, cloaked by Dr. Jose Reyes. Ebony Simone Rollins. Yeah. Emilia Rusak. Andy T. Arlen J. Terrell. Alan Valadez. Raquel Vigoria. Adriana Watson. Zaid Zahour. We would also like to recognize Annie Washio, who cannot be here in person, but hopefully is joining her class virtually today. Congratulations to all of our White Coat recipients.
Right, we're not quite done yet. There's one last step in today's ceremony. So as commitment to their new status as student clinicians, today's recipients will recite the White Coat Oath, witnessed by you, their closest supporters. Leading the class of fall 2025 in the White Coat Oath will be the Dean of the School of Naturopathic Medicine, Dr. Jessica Mitchell. Dr. Mitchell began the naturopathic medicine program at Sonoran University of Health Sciences after receiving her Bachelor of Science in Psychobiology from Binghamton University in New York. After completing a general medicine residency, Dr. Mitchell went on to be the first pediatric medicine resident at Sonoran University. During her residency, she collaborated with researchers at ASU on biomedical treatments of autism. Dr. Mitchell was a founding member of the Pediatric Association of Naturopathic Physicians and the American Board of Naturopathic Pediatrics. White Coat recipients, please rise as I bring Dr. Mitchell to the podium to lead you in the White Coat Oath.
Thanks. Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I state your name.
I,
As a student of the Sonoran University of Health Sciences, will enter the clinical portion of my educational training with an open mind and an eager spirit. I will incorporate the information that I have learned in the classroom with the knowledge that is now being passed on to me by my clinical supervisors. As a student clinician, I will parallel my therapeutic approach to the basic principles of naturopathic medicine. First, do no harm. The healing power of nature. Identify and treat the cause. Treat the whole person. Physician as teacher. And prevention is the best cure. I will treat each patient individually. I will look for the cause and treat the whole person. Each time I wear my white coat, I will do so with honor for those that trust me, with an open mind for those that are educating me, and with respect and responsibility for those that have paved the way before me in this profession. Congratulations, class of fall 2025. Welcome to the clinic.
Please turn around. Let everybody see you in your nice brand new face. Thank you, everyone. This concludes our celebration for today. I ask that everyone please remain in place until the white coat recipients have recessed from the auditorium.
Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive. Stopping me.